everybody. This is the segment where I get to chat with a really good friend. And I am so pleased that he took some time for me today. The one, the only, Ronnie Marmo! Hello, my friend. How are you?
You are amazing. I miss that energy. I need it. I need it right now.
Oh, I'm in the same boat. Isn't it crazy times?
You look great. And
well, thank you.
You're very classy with that t-shirt, I'll tell you that.
Did you already see? Yeah, baby. Let me shake it for you.
Come on, girl. I love you. You're the best.
My favorite part is this one.
If you take away the right to say fuck, you take away the right to say fuck the government.
Boy, that's right.
Truer words have never been spoken right now.
Isn't that so true?
We better not talk about that. This could get really ugly. I'll throw my laptop.
Uh-oh. Well, for those who don't know what this means I've seen Ronnie in his beautiful one-man show called Lenny Bruce. Oh, I have a flyer. Lenny Bruce. Is that mirrored? Can you read that? I don't know. I'm not a comedian. I'm Lenny Bruce. I didn't see the show one time. I've seen it six times.
It's amazing.
And that is the first for me. This is, you know, I never seen in my entire life a show freaking six times.
Thank you. Wow. That's really, I get it. Thank you. That means a lot.
It was amazing. Where did it take place? We haven't talked in a long time. So excuse me, dear friends. We met in Chicago, in that beautiful city when I worked for Teatro Zanzani. And we met on a radio show called The Man Cow.
Yeah. We met on Man Cow. That's great.
With Man Cow Mueller. And he stepped in. Just woke up with a cup of coffee.
Yeah. Oh, is that? Yeah, I just walked in and the rest is history, right?
You blew it out of the park. We had eye contact and that was it.
Yeah, we were pals ever since.
That is so true.
You know, it's very rare that you make a friend like that. It was really great. So.
That is so true. That is very, very true.
Yeah. And you, your show, come on. It was by far... And you know I'm not just saying this because we're doing this. I always say this. It was by far the best show in Chicago, Teatro Zanzani. It was awesome. My daughter and I went on my birthday, and it was just incredible. I loved it so much. You know that. I'm obsessed.
It was great. It was such a pleasure for me that I had the chance to get to spoil you on your birthday, being by yourself, you know, in a town. Well, you're surrounded by great fans, but you don't have friends and family around. Although you had your daughter with you, that was like very special.
That was the big treat. But you're right. Normally speaking, that's true. You know, it's like you go, you do these shows in these cities. Chicago, I left a piece of my heart there. I love that city.
We got that in common. That city, isn't it something?
Something special there. And so, but you do the show and people like love it and, blah, 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 and all that. And I'm very grateful. But then you're right. You spend a lot of time by yourself because those aren't the people you know, you know. So it was nice to connect with you. So
that was very true. Yeah, it's a glamorous life. You do your show, you shake 300 hands, and then everybody gets home inspired, and you go home by yourself.
You go home and you drink a lot of hot tea and stare out the window and wonder if you want to do it again tomorrow.
Right, out of a hotel room.
I'm eating too much gum right now. I'm littering. I don't care.
Now you're in trouble.
I never do that, okay? So what? If this is the worst, you know what I mean? If this is what as bad as it gets, we're going to be okay. By the way, I had to come outside. This is my apartment, but I'm a little anxious today. I'm like getting a little bananas. 5 weeks I've been sitting in this apartment. So I was like, I'm taking it outside. I hope she's okay with that.
I love it. It seems like you have really nice sunshine in LA right now.
It's a little gloomy and overcast, but it's LA. So this
that's the perfect light then.
Oh, no. It's like 68 degrees. It's a little gloomy, kind of like my personality. A little gloomy, overcast.
Get out of here.
No, I'm okay.
I always love when you pull out your gangster.
I pull out my gangster?
Yeah. It's one of my favorites.
There's too many movies.
That's very true. Maybe this is a good moment to show people what you have been up to in your career.
Wow.
I prepared a little snippet.
Oh, wow.
Of all the snippets, I have to say, the adults only. Oh, my God.
I knew you were going to talk about that.
That was, I mean, I love, I want to hang with that character.
I played him Crotch. Crotch, the singer of a punk band called the Crotch Mob, and also the manager of a sex shop.
Hold on. Let's have them a look at it.
Ted, can we talk for a second?
Hold up, boss man.
Sweet Jesus. Okay. Before we get to whatever it is you want to talk about, I would like to address a work-related gripe.
Sure.
Can you stop calling me Ted? Please? My name is Crotch. It's simple. Really. I mean, it's obvs, man. It's one syllable. It rolls right off the tongue.
Funny, right?
I knew. Oh my God! Play my leg! Play my leg!
I knew you'd like it. I knew it.
Ah, oh, so good. But your biggest fan pool is out of what series would you say? Where did you collect the most fans?
I would say probably General Hospital originally, you know. And those fans are the best because honestly they're loyal. I've been off the show 5-6 years, I don't know how long. I was on for 3 years. And they all come and support every show I do, every play I do. They watch every TV show. They write me notes. Once they love you, they own you. And I mean that in the best way. And yeah. It's like, but I would say that. But I would say over the last 2.5 years, I've been doing the Lenny Bruce show. And I've probably done the show for over 20,000 people in 2.5 years. And so, which is crazy to even think of that.
That's crazy. 20,000.
Yeah, yeah. And people... it's nice to be recognized for what you love. It's very rare in this world. And there's a Harley Davidson. I don't know if you hear that.
Oh, I love it.
Awesome. So anyway, so that's I would say that. But I've been very blessed. I've been able to make a living at this since pretty much since the beginning. It's been about the last real job I had out of show business was August of 98. So what is that? 22 years. It'll be 22 years. The last year, I mean, I've done a lot in show business, writing, directing, but outside of show business. The last time I had to say, would you like a Coke with that? You know what I mean? said that. Which is no, there's nothing wrong with that. I just sucked at it. I was the worst waiter in the whole world.
Oh my God. I want to order a Coke with you.
No, I would bring over like 3 Cokes because the lady would break my balls and I'd say, and she go, I just asked for one. I said, yeah, I know, but you're going to break my balls in 5 minutes. So just take all 3, please. My boss would go, get over here. I said, what I do? I'm getting a lady set up for the next half hour. Everybody was so mad at me, you know.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah. So,
what are you you did big things like Back in the Day, Criminal Minds, Hooked, Lethal Weapon. Holy crap.
I wanted to come by and tell you that I'm whacking that spick, Anthony Rodriguez. World champion, I don't give a fuck. The cocksucker put his hands on a mean man. Broke my rib.
Then we heard all about your escapade.
You're lucky.
You're lucky I decided to take the car as partial payment. You know, because I'm not really into these muscle cars. I'm a caddy guy myself, as you know. You know, in fact, I'm gonna sell your car and I'm gonna get myself another caddy.
Hi. You look great. I'm glad you came.
It's an honest life. You'll have a reason to get up every morning. You'll have money at the end of every week. You could buy things.
I'm an actor, you know that. I'm down on my luck right now, that's all.
Hey, hon, can you give me a hand in here?
1 second, babe. No, right now, you're embarrassing yourself.
What am I looking at?
That's a fork, Mr. Cusimano.
No, it's crusted marinara. Now get your head out of your ass, Larry, and go rewash all the flatware.
Ah, I'm not in the mood.
Excuse me?
Yeah, I've been very lucky. The last couple of years, I had a couple of wonderful guest stars on Lethal Weapon and Criminal Minds. And Criminal Minds is great. It aired the other night, which early in my career, I'd be like, I'm on TV, guys. Now in my career, I go, great, I'm going to get a residual. I don't even think about telling anybody. I'm just so happy. I'll probably get $30 for that. You know, that's how it goes. But I'm still very grateful. It was a cool role. It was great.
Well, yeah. Being all locked down, I'm secretly following you. You have this wonderful daily bachelor. Can I call it a cooking, washing, household?
Don't call it a cooking. The title says it all. The title is, I do mostly cooking, but I'm trying to evolve. The title is A Bachelor's Guide to Domestication with Ronnie Marmo. That's the name of the show. So I'm working towards domestication. So this is for my mother, Rosalie. She's gonna sit with me while I cook. Like this? I got no room in my kitchen.
You gotta fry first.
Can I pound with the grater?
How am I doing? Good? Vegetable oil. This is nerve-wracking. Pam, whatever the hell her name is. Should I use that? No, Pam! It's too late! I put the Pam! I'm stuck with the Pam!
The three more chickens, the bread. Pieces of chicken, the bread. This looks like Shanghai. I don't know who made this.
Is that nice? Or is my moot's too thick? Don't talk like that in front of your mother.
Listen, I'm bleeding from my feet. Literally bleeding from my feet. All right, I'm stressed out, I'm sweating. I lost 12 pounds in the last half hour. Yes, this looks so good. Where's my other mitt? Taking it out.
Who am I kidding? This is tonight. How's it guys? One more to make sure that wasn't a fluke.
And today's my 28th episode. I don't know.
And wow.
And I've been doing my own. Yeah, it's been great. It's been great.
Awesome. It's well, great. I will leave a link for everybody to click on your fan page.
Yeah.
So that I can follow this because it's quite hilarious.
Well,
I can cook.
People tell me, "Oh, you're so funny. How do you do it?" I go, "No. It's completely genuine. I have no idea what I'm doing in the kitchen. My mother.
That's why it's so good."
And then credit cards are horrible because that's who feeds me is my credit card. And now I'm literally taking care of myself. I know that sounds bizarre. And this morning I asked my daughter, who's 12, I said, "Hey, Tuesday night when you come over, why don't you give me a haircut on the air live?" And she's 12. She's like, "I can't, look at that hair. I can't give you a haircut." I said, "I need a freaking haircut. Look at this. I look like, Dr. J had a baby with, I don't know who else. What do I look like? I don't know. It looked like from Welcome Back, Carter. I don't know if you remember that show.
Yeah. It's getting a little out of hand now. Yeah.
I'm looking for one of those like underground prohibition haircuts. You know, like a Snipeasy. Hey, Snipeasy.
I saw today on Facebook someone giving a manicure through the where you put the mail in through the door.
Hustler.
So someone was sitting outside doing. That's what I need.
No, I know. I'm seriously, at this point, I'm just letting it go.
Well, did she sign up? Are we going to see her cut your hair?
She said, "I will, Dad, but I'm not going to be, you're not going to be happy." I said, "But that negativity is scaring me. Like, let's keep it positive, kid, you know?" But I told her, "I need like an underground Snipeasy, you know? I'm looking for like a, I don't know if anybody's doing these haircuts, you know?" But I've been very safe. I've been playing this cool. I've been respecting the hell out of what's going on. But I need a freaking haircut because it's literally going to look like 1987 again. And that was not pretty. You ready for this, Jack?
Oh! Oh!
Look at that hair. It's like a Corvette.
I wow. Have you know what? Don't get a haircut. I think you can. You should just get that mullet again.
That wasn't a mullet. It was all the whole thing. How about this guy?
Oh,
that jerk.
Is he waiting in your bedroom for you?
Yeah. If he was, it wouldn't look pretty, I'll tell you that. I mean, you're so funny.
Oh, you're funny. Well, you're in lockdown. Things don't look good, but we're hoping. Do you think you will go back to Chicago? Are you going to pick up Lenny Bruce one more time? Or are you... What are you going to do with the show? What's happening?
I have no doubt that I will go back and finish what I started in Chicago. I'm not going out this way. So I'm definitely going back. I've done 85 performances there, and I really want to get to 100. So that's my plan. Look at this here. Look at this here. Oh, geez Louise. I want to get to 100 performances terribly. And that's not the only reason I'm doing it, but I made a promise that I would finish there, and I don't think this is the way to go out. So I will go back. In addition to that, I spoke to my my booking company, Columbia Artists, the other day, and they're setting up a national tour. And they said, oddly, we're probably going to get more bookings than we would have after this, because it's a very simple show, and it's only me. It's relatively cheap, as it were, and people are going to have to put up content. So he seems to think, like, not to sound opportunistic, but you're going to get a lot of calls because they have to do something. Might as well,
well
be your.
I love it.
But we'll see. We'll see.
That would be a great payoff.
Maybe I'll wear a mask as Lenny Bruce. That'll be weird.
Mask, you know. Doesn't serve the purpose.
Well, whatever it takes, I'll do it. I realize art is important and people.
We just put you in a glass box.
Well, you wouldn't be the first person to do that.
Oh, I want to hear that story.
Yeah, I got to go. Oh, my phone's ringing. I got to go. Hello? Yeah, I got to go. You know, by the way, that's a really interesting idea. Put me in a glass box.
There you go.
You're very, like, smart, you know? You're very smart.
And once in a while. Once.
And you're crazy talented. Really. You're a friggin'
Well, mature. Before I finish this interview, I want to give everybody a snippet from your show. And yeah, this is my favorite pieces I chose to present, Lenny Bruce.
How many people in this club tonight have ever used the word? Come on, raise your hands, don't be shy. Let's get really honest with each other. Are you fucking kidding me? Yes. Thank you. You, sir. Have you ever had your blah blah? Listen, it's a simple yes and no answer. But remember, it's illegal to say it and illegal to do it within the city limits of San Francisco. Okay, from a show of hands, how many men in this room have ever had their blah blah? Come on, put them up. Okay, keep them up there for a second. Keep them up for a second. You poor son of a bitch, really? Keep him up. Well, maybe he's with his daughter. That's what he's like. Keep him up, fellas. Keep him up. Okay, from a show of hands, how many men in this room have ever blah a blah? Somebody's not telling the truth. Oh, one guy's telling the truth. That a boy. She's looking at me like, please, no. You men, have you ever blah a blah? The guy's in the back and he's like, and this guy's like, I'm gonna kill this guy. This is the dirtiest show I've ever done. Totally atrociously blasphemous, just the way I like it. If anyone has found this obscene, you're full of blah, and I hope you never get your blah blah again. You bunch of cocksuckers. You put guys on a desert island, they'll do it to mud. What?
Like, you caught your husband with mud, you were somehow able to get overseas, you know? Mud! Don't talk to me, that's all! You piece of shit! Go with your mud, have fun! You want dinner? Get your mud to make dinner for you, that's all!
No, you can't get angry at them, you know? You can't want to leave them for just that. At all. No. You know, a lot of marriages went west, you know. They split up in my generation because ladies didn't know that guys were different. I mean, different. You know, it's very tough for chicks to realize that although we speak the same language, you're different. I mean, you could have babies, you know, it's so different. It's like ladies are one emotion and guys detach. I mean, we don't consciously detach, you know, but we just do detach. You know, it's like It's like a lady can't go through a plate glass window and go to bed with you 5 seconds later. Maybe you. But guys can have head-on collisions with Greyhound buses in disaster areas. Everybody's laying dead on the highway. And on the way to the hospital, in the ambulance, the guy makes a play for the nurse. How can he do a thing at a time like that? I got horny. You what? I got hot, you know. How can you be hot? Your foot is cut off and you're dead. I don't know, you know. He's an animal. He got hot with his foot cut off. I guess I'm an animal, you know. I mean, where'd you get hot at, you know? The nurse's uniform, I mean. He's a moron. He's an animal. No, it's just that guy's detached. You know, it has nothing to do with liking or loving.
Beautiful.
You're the best.
I hate that I won't be in Chicago if you go back. But it is what it is, and I hope our paths will somehow cross.
There's always a weekend trip.
In my closet again, I guess, for now, but...
There's always a weekend trip, you never know.
That is very true, yeah.
I'm just saying.
Well, I cross my fingers that things will go well, and I miss you, my man.
I miss you. We really
had fun in Chicago, so...
Yeah, it was a great time. We will, we're just getting started. We're just getting
right.
Started. We're just getting started. Don't you worry. I, you know what I'm saying.
Yes. It's gonna be great. Keep going with the domestication. I really hope that this will pay off.
Listen, you know what it is? It's paying off of my sanity every day. That's the reason I'm doing it, honestly.
Very true.
It's, I just need to be, to, I don't know. I need to have a laugh. I'm sure other people need a laugh right now. And we'll do our best, you know. But I'm happy to be on your show. This is your second episode, and I'm so honored that Ooh. I was going to.
Thank you so, for jumping into the cold water, not knowing what this is all. Well, I love you.
Listen, I love you, and I know what it's all about. I'm lucky to be opposite you, so thank you. You know.
Awesome.
You're awesome.
Well, we'll talk soon.